Hey guys, today on Landbeat, we're going to be talking about one of the unique ecosystems here in southern Missouri, but it can be found throughout a lot of the southern United States. We're going to be talking about glades and prescribed fire. So glades are a really cool ecosystem, very shallow soil, lots of rock outcroppings usually found, so lots of forbs and grasses, and you can even get into finding some native hardwood species, like here we have the chinkapin oak. Here on this farm, they're not very common. We probably have 10 to 15 acres of glades. I have a whole 900 acres that we manage. So it's a very unique, but the cool thing about this feature is it can provide incredible brood rearing possibilities and highly diverse ecosystems or highly diverse acres here on our farm. This one's just recently burned. As you can still see the smoke, it's not completely burned up, but we're setting back the woody vegetation, trying to stimulate new forbs, more herbaceous plants, and provide great brood rearing habitat for the wild turkeys. Pretty common on these glades is to see grasses continue to colonize post fire. So year one after a fire, it's lots of forbs and some grasses, but year three post fire, it starts to be a lot more grasses. So we're trying to burn these back every couple of years, stimulate forbs and control the grasses, try to set back some of the woody encroachment. And as we walk through here, you'll see just an amazing possibility with lots of forbs already starting to germinate and are already green, but there's lots of bare ground for turkey poults. So we're gonna walk through here and show you some of the great features of this glade. Yeah, so you can see all the rocks, the small rocks even, not counting the bluff rock that we were standing on that's here. So it's very shallow soil. It takes certain species that can just colonize this. Of course, this is not a great place for a food plot, nor would we even try. It's a west-facing slope. It gets very hot and dry in the summer, but that means that we're gonna have some bare ground, and even during the summer months when a lot of our woodlots or woodlands start to grow up thick in vegetation, these still have sparse pockets that turkey poults can move around chasing insects, because the amount of flowers that are growing here attract a lot of insects. So this is an incredible place for turkeys to spend their summers. You still have one of the biggest problems that you'll find on glades is eastern red cedar encroachment, like you see right here. We had to cut all of these cedars back. You'll see the skeletons. They're continuing to burn. This is second burn post fire. So these were cut, or post cutting. These were cut 2 years ago, burned within a few months. Now we're back on it 2 years later, burning it again. And you can see we're getting a lot of these tops broke down with the fire, and they're still providing benefit though, because it's good escape cover for turkey poults and fawns that can get around that woody vegetation and survive predation. So really cool species grow here. We have rough blazing star, one that's we don't see a lot of, cylindrical blazing star. We have Ozark coneflower, one of the echinaceas. We have pale purple coneflower here. Of course, Missouri coneflower and black-eyed Susans. Bunch of other really cool, we got scarlet Indian paintbrush. We can go on and on, but those are some of the really cool features that you'll find on this glade in particular. And so if you're a person that's really into wildflowers, glades are something we can really hang our hat on, especially when you get into glade restoration. But as far as game management, these can provide great fawning cover, great brood rearing cover on years two and three between fire. It's great nesting cover. So if you have a big glade, you want to try to maybe section it off so you burn a portion of it, so you've got brood rearing post fire 1 year and nesting cover immediately adjacent on the other side that you didn't burn that year. So you're not completely cleaning the slate and making it all brood rearing, but you can have nesting and brood rearing on that same glade. So just a really cool feature. This glade in particular has a creek that runs at the bottom side of it, so it's kind of a good vista or lookout spot. You get to see the cool creek. There's a beaver complex over here, and then of course the glade and the view. So this is one of my favorite features on the entire farm, but from a recreational standpoint, it's mainly about flowers. It's mainly about enjoying the glade, because there's not much you can do on a glade as far as making food plots or making pasture for cows or growing crops. Pretty much a glade, you just got to manage it as a glade.